The NetBeans environment has a very powerful debugger built into it. In this video, we'll use the NetBeans debugger to step through a very simple Java program that reads 5 numbers into an array, finds the maximum number in the array, and then prints out the maximum number. Before starting the debugger, we'll insert a breakpoint at the first line in main. The program will run normally until it reaches the first breakpoint, when we'll have the opportunity to interact with it. We insert the breakpoint by clicking to the left of the line of code. NetBeans displays a red square to the left and highlights the line of code in red to let us know there is a breakpoint. Now we'll push the debug button to start debugging. Alternatively, we could right-click on the file in the project view and select Debug File. You'll see that the program has started and the line with the breakpoint is highlighted in green, indicating the program has stopped here. Along the top, we now have buttons to stop the debugger, pause, play, which means to continue to the next breakpoint, step over expression, step into, and step out. Step over means to run to the next line of code. If this line of code is a method call, the entire method will complete. Note the green arrow has moved to the next line of code. We can now look at the Variables tab and see that my array is visible, and by clicking on the plus, we see that it has 5 zeros in it, indexed from 0 to 4. We now press Step Into. This will actually enter the method and stop at its first line of code. We now step through the method using Step Over. After some number of steps, you'll see that the buttons are grayed out. This is because the program is waiting for input. The Output tab is where println's are displayed and where we type input. Clicking on that, we can enter the number and continue. Rather than stepping through this entire method, I'll use Step Out, which runs the method to completion and stops at the line following it. We're now back in main at the println. I'll add another breakpoint inside FindMax, and then hit the play button to run to the next breakpoint. On the Variables tab, we can add our own watches. Those are expressions we want to track. For example, I can double-click and enter array bracket 3, and then I will always be able to see that value. Another thing I can do is evaluate expressions. On the Debug menu, select Evaluate Expression. A new window appears. I'll step to the if statement. If I want to know whether it will be true or false, I can put that expression in the window and push the green button. You'll see that it is false. You can enter complicated expressions here. For example, I can say array 3 equals 9. Going back to the Variables tab, you can see that the third element in the array has actually changed its value. Using a debugger can allow you to go through your program step by step and see what is happening and where it is going wrong. You can download the project used in this video at java.martincarlyle.com.